Welcome to the SOFiCAD online documentation. In this series of tutorials, we will deal with the fundamental aspects of creating reinforcement plans using SOFiCAD. SOFiCAD is an add-in for AutoCAD that enables the creation of reinforcement bars and meshes, and provides tools for the automatically generation of area reinforcement schedules and much more. The SOFiCAD reinforcement objects are fully compatible with AutoCAD commands and workflows, which makes SOFiCAD intuitive and easy to use. The support of features like copy in clipboard and stretch provides a huge reusability for our done plans and views, which means greater productivity with shorter working times in our future projects. The wide range of graphical options, the flexibility of its annotation labels, and the capability of defining the physical properties of rebar and meshes allow SOFiCAD to support the creation of reinforcement plans in every national standard with metric units. In this video, we will take a general overview of the SOFiCAD reinforcement workflow. These demonstrations are not intended to be followed as a tutorial. The main features will be explained in detail in the following videos of this playlist. We start selecting one of the pre-configured SOFiCAD templates. SOFiSTiK has a suitable label and units configuration for this example. Once in a drawing, we can access to the ribbon. As we see on the screen, it has four main areas, commands for the creation and modification for rebar and meshes. Common features for rebars and meshes like member assignment or schedule. And the settings menus. Before starting, I set the standard for the shape code to ISO and activate the real representation of the bars. The first thing we need to start creating reinforcement are formwork lines. I will draw sun rectangles as they were the top view and section of a slab. Now, we can use this line as reference for the definition of the rebar shape. I start creating the edge reinforcement in section. This green line is the bar mark view. This object is responsible for the physical definition of the reinforcement position. It also keeps track of the total number of elements of its bar mark that have been created so far. The yellow one is a shape in formwork. This is just a graphical representation of the rebar that has no influence on the total number of the bar mark. In fact, if I mirror it, the total number of elements remains zero. In order to count elements, we must create labels using laying commands. To count those shapes in formwork, the most appropriate command is pointer. SOFiCAD just considers the number of elements displayed by the reinforcement labels. If the labels display no number, then nothing will be counted. In case we want to place rebars in a certain interval, the command we need is linear laying, arrow. By selecting the laying length and the distance between bars, we can create a linear laying, which calculates the needed number of bars to cover the selected length. By checking the bar mark view, we notice the total number of bars has properly increased. To do the other sides, we can save some time mirroring the layings, or using some automatic commands like polylaying. For area reinforcement, we also could use the command arrow defining every bar manually, or we can use the command based on AS values to let it be automatically generated. This command calculates the overlap lengths and give us the option to determine it where they must be placed. Furthermore, it can read the structural calculations results from SOFiSTiK and generate the required reinforcement automatically. In case we use meshes, the procedure is similar. In this example, we use the command polygonal mesh layout to generate a mesh field within the boundaries defined by a polyline. Like any other SOFiCAD reinforcement object, mesh fields can be easily modified through its info edit options or using AutoCAD modification commands. After generating the reinforcement, we can create a schedule for production. SOFiCAD also offers a tool to import views from a Revit plan into a DWG file. Every view will be saved in an independent file, and then, they all will be linked to the active drawing as external references. Now we can start creating our reinforcement as usual. SOFiCAD detect formwork lines also in external references, so we can use them to define the shape of bars or stirrup meshes. In this example we are generating the reinforcement for a foundation. We have created the bottom layer, and then we have used it as template to create the other bar marks quicker. The commands copy and modify, mirror, and stretch are good tools to improve our productivity and avoid errors. If changes were to be made to the Revit project, exporting the plan again would automatically update the DWG files. The reinforcement can then be easily adjusted. Once the modifications are done, we can create a difference schedule, which compares the current DWG file with the previous one, and reports just the modified elements. I hope you find useful the system that SOFiCAD offers for the creation of reinforcement plans. In this series of tutorials I will show you step by step, how to use the main features. In the next chapter I will begin with the creation of bar mark views. Thank you for watching this tutorial.